Welcome to Minity Maths. In this video we are going to provide some GCSE exam style practice questions relating to nets of 3D shapes. For a refresher on this topic, watch the video linked above and in the description, below. Subscribe and hit the notification bell for weekly videos. Let's have a look at a typical GCSE style question about nets. This question provides four nets and asks you to identify the ones which show the nets of a cube. For this question, we can visualize how the net would fold up into a 3D shape. Let's start with shape A. Imagine this square was the base of the cube. These two squares could be folded upwards to form two sides of the cube. And this square could be the top. However, this square would overlap the one we already have at the top. And while this square would form the side, we would be missing the other side here. Try visualizing this same net using a different square as the base. You will always end up with overlapping squares and missing sides. Try to visualize the rest of these nets in a similar way and pause the video while you do this. Remember, there may be more than one way to fold these nets up. If you are finding this challenging, try using a piece of paper cut into the same shape as the net. So we can see that nets B and D are the ones which will form a cube. The question is worth 2 marks, and we would get 1 mark for each correct answer, but we would lose a mark if we circled an extra, incorrect answer. Have a look at this second question. We are given a net and the names of some 3D shapes. Let's see what the shapes look like and if they match the net. During the exam, you would have to either visualize these shapes or sketch them out. The triangular-based pyramid does not contain any rectangular faces, whereas the net in the question has 3 rectangular and 2 triangular faces. So we can be sure the net is not of a triangular-based pyramid. We can clearly see the net does not contain a circular face, as the cone does, so we know this isn't the correct answer. The rectangular-based pyramid does contain a rectangular face, but as there is only one of these, this doesn't match the net we are given. However, we can see that the triangular prism has 3 rectangular faces, along with 2 triangular faces at either end. This matches the net we have been given and is therefore the correct answer. This question is worth 1 mark, which is given for the correct answer with no other answers circled. For the third question, we are asked to work out the surface area of the 3D shape by using its net. As we have 3 rectangular faces and 2 triangular faces, we can work these out individually first, then add them all together to find the total area. It may help to watch our video about compound shapes, linked above, if you need a recap. So, let's start with finding the area of one triangular face first. The formula for finding the area of a triangle is half times base times height. In the diagram we are given the length of the base, 2 centimeters, and the perpendicular height of the triangle, 3 centimeters. We can now calculate the area of the triangular face. Because the net contains 2 triangular faces, we can multiply our answer by 2, to find the area of both. Let's make a note of this and move on to finding the area of the rectangular faces. To find the area of a rectangle, we just need to multiply the length by the width. In this case, we multiply the length of 7 cm by the width of 2 cm. As there are 3 rectangular faces, we can multiply our answer by 3, to find the total area of all 3 rectangles. Now that we have found the area for the triangular and the rectangular faces, we can add these together to find the total area of the net, which in turn provides us with the surface area of the 3D shape. This question is worth 3 marks. 1 mark will be awarded for finding the area of the triangular faces, 1 mark for the area of the rectangular faces, and the third mark for finding the total surface area of the shape. Thanks for watching Minity Maths. Good luck in the exams.